Okay, folks. God bless you guys. Was that fun last night? All glory to the Lord God. I want to give it all to the Lord. Took 16 years to get it, but I got it. Anyway, it's definitive. I'm going to do another video. And maybe today, maybe tomorrow, I don't know, where I clump all those similar things together. All the bugs go together, all the dead sheep go together, all the transmutation circles with all the girls, all of it is going to be its own separate header. Like, let's go through all these girls that all have transmutation circles on them and they have bugs in them. Okay, that's wonderful. And then we're going to go through, look at all these altars that are all dead sheep. What's with this, what's with all this stuff repetitively in different venue after different venue after different venue after different venue? It's definitive. It's been solved. I'm going to rearrange and repackage the same material. Last night, I was like, I was like, tell me it ain't true. Anyway, it's, it's, sorry. It's really overwhelming, isn't it? It's overwhelming. So anyway, thanks for bearing with me last night. I was like, I was just like, oh my gosh. But anyway, so here's what I want to do today. This is going to be fun. Now that you know the truth, let's just apply it. Those who hide their plans, they turn everything upside down. You see back there on my wall, you see that whole written out thing? The Lord told me to have that printed and put on my wall. That's the Acts of Peter right there, verses 37, 38, and 39. It was conveniently left out of the Bible, and I know why now, because if that would have been in the Bible, this thing would have been solved a long time ago. And when they hung Peter up in the manner he desired, he said, "Hearken unto me, those who have ears to hear, those who are able to hear, hearken unto what I will declare to you at this special time as I hang here. Learn ye the mystery of all things and what it was from the beginning." And so Peter's been hung up upside down and he's talking to the crowd. And he says, "Learn the full mystery of Christ, unless you make the things of the right hand as a..." Now don't forget, he's hung upside down. He's crucified upside down. And he says, "Unless you make the things of the right hand as those of the left, and those of the left as those of the right, and those above as those below, and those behind as those before, you will have no knowledge of the kingdom." That's what Peter said on the cross when he was crucified upside down. All that means is just turn it upside down the other way. Same thing as 100% nylon. Turn it upside down, 100% no line. It's the exact same message, packaged differently for the guy that was supposed to deliver it to y'all. Isn't that just amazing? Now watch this. Now watch. It's going to be super fun. You remember Eros and Psyche? Okay, well, watch this. I'm going to go like this. I'm going to show you what I did. Watch this. Okay, so it says Cupid and Psyche, right? I'll hit my back button. And you'll see I did a search for Eros and Psyche. See right there? What came up? Cupid and Psyche, Myth of Eros and Psyche. And I just clicked on the first one right there. So I'm going to go back and click on that. Cupid and Psyche. Cupid and Psyche is a story originally from Metamorphosis. Oh, you mean like a transmutation circle? Now, also called the Golden Ass. We're going to look at that in just a sec. Written in the 2nd century AD by Lucius Aphilius, whatever. It concerns the overcoming of obstacles to the love between psyche, look at this, soul, breath of life, and Eros, which means love, desire. It really means desire. So, breath of life and desire between psyche. So let's look at obstacles between the love between psyche. Okay, and it says soul or breath of life and Cupid, which is Eros, love, which it's really desire. There are different types of love, and this is really important to understand. In the accident, no. In John 21, when Jesus is talking to Peter, and Jesus has already been crucified, he's been resurrected, and Peter's out fishing. They don't know what to do. Jesus has been crucified, and they're like, well, let's go fishing. They go fish, and he says, cast your net on the right side of the boat. And they could barely bring in the catch. And Jesus and Peter goes, oh my gosh, it's the Lord. And he jumps in the water. He swims over to him. Jesus asked him three times, do you love me? If you love me, then feed my sheep. Peter, do you love me? You do? Then feed my sheep. He said, do you love me? He said, do you? Well, let me show you the word for love real quick. Okay, watch the difference in the word love here. This is fascinating. So when they had dined, Jesus said to Simon Peter, Simon, son of Jonas. Now listen, let me ask you a question. Why isn't he calling him Peter? Petros. He already named him Petros back in Matthew 16 before he was crucified. He said, when he asked his disciple, who do people say that I am? Everybody, got the answer wrong except for Peter. And Peter said, I say you're the Messiah. And Jesus said, blessed are you, Simon Barjona, for flesh and blood did not reveal this to you, but my Father who is in heaven. And I'm going to name you Petros. So right then and there, he named him Petros. And he says, and upon this rock, Petra, I will build my church, and I will give to you the key to the kingdom of heaven. He said keys, but if you look it up, the word is kleis. It means key. I'll give you the key to the kingdom of heaven. Kleis. Okay, so why is he calling him Simon, son of Jonah? Right here. Jesus has already been crucified. He's already risen from the dead. Why isn't he going like, hey, what's up, Petros? It's me. He's sitting there. They had dined. He said to Simon Peter, Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou, look at the word lovest. It means to love in a social or moral sense. This word right here. Agapeo. Agapo. And then and says, you know I love thee, Lord. And what does he say? Feed my lambs. Let me ask you a question. What are all the images I show you on these altars? What's the altar, Saint Peter? It's a dead sheep. It's a lamb. It's a dead lamb. It's a dead sheep. Wow. Wow, that's called the altar of Saint Peter, isn't it? And then a second time, Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me? And he said unto him, yea, Lord, thou knowest that I love thee. And look at the word he Jesus used. The same word, agape. Lovest thou me? And then he said, then feed my sheep. And then he said unto him a third time, Simon, son of Jonas, look at that, look at this. Lovest thou me? Look at the word he used here. Why didn't he use the same word here, agape? Agape. And then he used the word that Peter was using back towards him. He said, Lord, you know I love you. Look at this, 53:68. To be a friend, to be fond of an individual. But he wasn't saying, I agape love you. It's a different type of love. One is sacrificial. One is a complete sacrificial type of love. The other one is, friendly. One is like Eros, like erotic. And he says, do the third time, Simon, son of Jonas, look at the word right here in red. It's 53:68. He switched to the word Peter was using. It changed. Look at that. So Peter was saying, Lord, thou knowest that I love 53:68 you, that I'm a friend of, I'm fond of you, I have an affection, denoting personal attachment as a matter of sentiment of feeling, while G25 is wider, embracing, look, while G25 is wider, embracing especially the judgment and deliberate assent of the will as a matter of principle, duty, or propriety. That is huge, because guess what? I'm going to tell you straight up. That's what I had to do. I had to put my own selfish life behind me and say, everybody else is more important than me now. And this truth that you've shown me is more important than me. It's bigger than me. It's bigger than my marriage. It's bigger than my kids. It's bigger than everything. And I owe it to everybody. I owe it to Jesus to show everybody. That was back in 2002. Wow. Different word for love. So let's go over it one more time. So Jesus, when they had dined, said to Simon Peter, Simon, son of Jonas, do you look, love me? Like, do you agape love me? Do you love me no matter what? Are you willing to lay down your life for me in a dutiful sense? And then he said unto him, yea, Lord, look, thou knowest that, look at the word here, I love thee. Look right here. I love thee. Okay. To be a friend, to be fond of an individual, have an affection. So right here, Peter says, yes, Lord, you know that I love you. Let me highlight these for you guys. He said, I'm going to highlight Peter in blue, and I'll highlight Jesus in yellow. Watch this. Okay, so Jesus says, do you love me? He's using agape. Peter says, yes, I love you, phileo, because phileo means, yeah, I'm your friend, you know, I love you like that. And that's not what Jesus is asking. He's like, no, do you love me sacrificially? And Peter's answering, well, I love you like a friend, you know, like, so the word Peter is using is different. Yes, Lord, you know I love you, to be a friend, to be fond of. I'm going to do that with blue right there. Okay, look. And then he said, then feed my sheep, feed my lambs. Okay, why do you think everything I show you is dead sheep? Because you turn it upside down and you see the sheep. When you turn the virgin upside down, you see the dead sheep. That's how I was able to show you the sheep. How did Peter die? Oh, he was crucified upside down. Wow. Let's check it out. He said to him again, look at this, the second time. I'm going to highlight that. Simon, son of Jonas, look at this, 25. Lovest thou me? It's what's the word? Agape. Lovest thou me? He said unto him, yea, Lord, thou knowest that I phileo you. Not agape. He's like, you know I phileo you. To be friend, to be fond of an individual that is an object, have an affection for. A denoting personal attachment as a matter of sentiment or feeling. Watch this. He said unto him a third time. How many times did he deny Jesus? Three times is how many times. So he was restoring him right here. He said to him a third time, Simon, son of Jonas, look what Jesus said. Do you phileo me? And Peter was grieved. He said unto him the third time, lovest thou me? He said the third time, lovest thou me? And he said unto him, Lord, thou knowest all things, and thou knowest that I love thee. It's a different word. And then look what he says to him. Jesus said unto him, feed my sheep. Now get ready, the altar of St. Peter, folks. Look at what he says to Peter right now. This is huge. You've got to know this. So right then, Jesus was resurrected on the beach, eating fish. They pulled in the net. They could barely bring it in. Do you agape me? Do you agape me? Well, I phileo you, I phileo you. Well, do you phileo me? Well, I phileo you. Well, you're going to have to change that. It's going to have to be a different type of love. Verily I say unto thee, look at this. When thou was young, thou girdest thyself. To gird means, you know, you like put your belt around your tunic, thyself, and thou walkest where thou wouldest. But then when thou shalt be old, thou shalt stretch forth thy hands, and another shall gird thee and carry thee whether thou wouldest not go. Now watch this. This spake he, signifying by what, look at this, death he should glorify God. How did Peter die? He was crucified upside down. That was to let all us brothers know to see the truth. You got to turn everything upside down, or you'll know. That's why I told him, I'll give you the keys to the kingdom of heaven. Peter was the key to understanding this. Don't you get it? And unto you I will give the keys to the kingdom of heaven, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. So Jesus told him, your death is going to glorify God. Someone try and, you know, and argue with that right there for you trolls. There you go, guys. Y'all are done. There it is. His death should glorify God. So Peter was crucified upside down. And when he had spoken this, he said unto him, follow me. Okay, now, we're going to apply that scripture. Get ready to freak out. Because we've all been taken captive. And we were led astray to another place. They're the original inhabitants here. We're not. We got trapped in host bodies. That's what's up. Anyway, here we go. Okay, Cupid, Eros, and Psyche. Psyche, soul or breath. And Cupid, desire or love, Eros. It's where, you know, the word erotica comes from. And their ultimate union in a sacred marriage, although only in the extended narrative from its antiquity of the Aphelius, Eros and Psyche appear in the Greek art as early as the 4th and 5th century BC. The Neoplatonic elements and allusions to the mystery religions accommodate multiple interpretations. Okay, watch this. Here it is, Psyche and Amor, known as Psyche receiving Cupid's first kiss. A symbolic butterfly hovers over Psyche in a moment of innocence poised before sexual awakening. Told you so. That's why these girls have butterflies on them with a keyhole right in the middle. That's in all the folders I just showed you. Now watch this. Remember the Bound by Nothing Jaguar commercial? What's on the license plate? 911, 911, upside down, twice. How do you see it? It's 116, 116. Turn it upside down. By the way, Dave the Wave got it right on what the L and the O stand for. It goes to the Greek alphabet. I'll talk about it later. It means to kill lambs. Anyway, so here we go. Someone noticed that someone looked it up. This is a 1961 Jaguar. Why would they use a 1961 1961? You see, it's a reversal. It's a reversal. It's a 1961. Oh, you mean kind of like that. Yeah, like that. Y'all remember the Cranberries? Y'all remember this girl? I used to think this is a great song back in the day. Let's look at all the little kids. What are they all dressed as? Wait, let me go right here. What are all these little kids dressed as? They're all dressed as Cupid. Let me see if there's any of them with their bow and arrow. This is really a horrible thing when you see what it's really alluding to. Let's see. Here we go. Let's read the lyrics. Another head hangs lowly, child is slowly taken, and the violence caused such silence. Who are we mistaking? But you see, it's not me, it's not my family. In your head, they are fighting. So there's a fight going on in his head. Okay, and I'll skip the with their tanks and their bombs and all that. It's not really even, it's just filler. In your head, they are crying. In your head, zombie, zombie, zombie. A, E, A. In your head, zombie, zombie, zombie. All the little boys are dressed is arrows, is Cupid before the kiss. Innocence being destroyed. So, yeah. Here we go. Look at this. It's been the same old thing since. It's the same old thing since when? 1916. What an interesting. Why'd you pick 1916? Is that like when you're trying to make the allusion to the wars that, whatever you're trying to sort of plug in your video? No. It's the same thing as all of this. It's all the same. All of it. It's all the same. The tree of the knowledge of good and evil can only produce what it is. Do you understand? That's why when you're in the forest, you can't see that you're in the forest. You got to get taken out of it. And then you're like, ah, I used to be in the forest. Yeah. This is no, literally as profound as waking up in the movie The Matrix. That's how profound getting saved should be. It should be like, it's, and they've watered it down into people believing, oh, just raise your hand in church and get a Bible and you're saved. That's insane. So there you go. What's in your head? In your head, zombie, zombie, zombie. EIO. Oh, wow. That reminds me of EAO. They use that also for Apollyon. Let's take a look at let's take a look at the video for just a sec. And there is an X on the cross for the female chromosome. This is a mockery, guys. This is a sick, twisted mockery of little children. This is, I mean, this is insanity. You just couldn't see it before. She's mocking these little kids, calling them zombies. So, yeah, it's kind of a roller coaster, isn't it? Once you wake up. Toys in the attic. Yeah, that's a good one. The lock was the mouth of the devil I showed you. Just go back and re-listen to the music you used to listen to and wake up. This is real. You're in it. It shows them being policed. They have guards walking around them with guns. I mean, if this is supposed to be like an anti-war thing, it's only camouflage. That's all it is. It's really a spirit using a host body, doing a song, mocking everybody. That's all it is. The whole thing. That's all it is. And by the way, I've been through this video. I don't want to play a lot of it for codec reasons. But if you go watch it, it shows little kids, those all painted gold with their bow and arrow, just like Cupid, just like arrows. Sick. Thanks, someone that left this. Unbelievable. And man, I remember this song. I used to listen to it. I used to think it was a really great song. And as you go and you look at it and you look at the symbology and you see the little kids jumping, look, from right there, look, they're jumping from one side to the other and they're just literally mocking them. And remember, everything in a video is staged. There's production. Okay, you two guys, y'all jump ready right now. Ready, go. And two kids jump and they edit it in. It's a sick, twisted mockery. So now we've got it. It's totally solved. All you got to do is apply it. That's why they used a 1961 Jaguar. There's the Jaguar. There's the Bound by Nothing. So I can take that Jaguar and I'll try and go like that and see if I can get in there with it. No, couldn't get it. Me go back. There you go. 911, 911. They know it's coming. 1961 Jaguar, cranberry lyrics. It's the same old thing since 1916. In your head, zombie, zombie, zombie. You know, I saw Matt, I saw what's that movie? Madagascar with Alex the Lion, you know, and Velma, the giraffe guy, is in his pen, and Alex the Lion is trying to get him all ready. Oh, it's the people, it's the people. He's like getting all excited. And Melvin's like going, he doesn't want to come out or something, like he's not feeling well. And Alex turns upside down and looks him right in the straight and he goes, "It's all in your head. The whole thing's in your head." Just like the hieroglyph. The kid's got a dead sheep and there's a reptile. Same as Obama. What did Jesus say to Peter? Feed my sheep. Feed my sheep. He says three times, feed my sheep. I'm gonna feed my sheep. Feed my sheep. By the way, Peter, the way you die is gonna glorify God. Peter was crucified upside down. Let's just look at that last picture of the altar of Saint Peter. So we can just see it and prove it. Why do you think they called it the altar of Saint Peter? Why do you think they did that? Because they're mocking Peter. They pervert everything. They're a bunch of perverts. They turn everything upside down and backwards. It's a total perversion of everything. Exactly what it is. It's proven now. Y'all can all just be at peace. St. Peter's throne and altar, right there. Look at that. St. Peter's throne and altar. I'll just click on it. Hey, Peter, feed my sheep. There you go. Hey, Jonathan, feed my sheep. There you go. There. Okay, I'll take the virgin, turn it upside down. There's your dead sheep. Just fed the sheep. Here's a hieroglyph of Akhenaten and Nefertiti. I'll turn Nefertiti upside down. It's a dead sheep. I'm feeding the sheep. Here you go. There's the largest altar in the world. It's a big damn bug with a penis going in its mouth. There you go. The whole altar, the entire altar is a dead sheep. You know what? I'm going to click on this one because I cropped it and I didn't, I left the circle window out from above it. There you go. Someone tell me that's not a dead sheep. There's the eye. There's the eye. Nostril, nostril, teeth. Tongue sticking out. Those are the ears. There's a sheep right below it. No, sorry, we're done. We are done. Now, here's something supernatural that happened. When I loaded up that video last night, I didn't even know what to call it because I was in such a mood. I was just like, ow! Did you notice in that video last night? I was like, okay, guys, let's pull our money. Maybe we can buy the balloon, from the Wizard of Oz and get the red slippers and get the hell out of here, because it's like, we've been trapped on a planet we don't belong to. That's why the Bible says we're aliens here. We're not the locals. We're aliens. We got trapped here. We belong up there. They set a trap for us. So anyway, it's all proven out now. Everything's upside down and backwards. It's amazing. Okay, so check this out. So last night I was loading up that video in my Screencast-O-Matic. And guys, my computer, it eats up memory. The more of those videos you have stored, the more memory it eats. And so I have to delete them occasionally. So I have three different computers I work on, but I like this one the best because when I drag images on top, the image doesn't fade out. It's more crisp. So I use this computer a lot. So when I titled the video last night, I was like, Lord, what should I title it? And it was really weird. I couldn't really even think of what to title it. And I just went, oh yeah, I wrote O-O-H, capital O, capital H, capital Y-E-A-H, exclamation point, exclamation point. Put it in the field and I hit upload. When I looked up, it's like, it says it's recording number 50. I'm like, what? I didn't name it recording number 50. It's recording number 50 because in my Screencast-O-Matic, that's what number the program logged that video to be, recording number 50. Out of all the videos that have been deleted and then other ones that have come in, deleted, other ones that have done, deleted. So it keeps kind of a plus and minus of what videos are in there. So it designated it number 50. I heard the Lord say, look up the number 50. Strong's Concordance Hebrew 50. Y'all want to be encouraged? My father is rescue. Yeah, get us out of here. Just let's get a balloon. We'll get the balloon from the Wizard of Oz and I'll click my heels together. Dad's coming, folks. My father is rescue. Woo-hoo! Oh, that's funny. That's what I prayed in the alley when I got saved. Our Father who art in heaven. Dad's coming. Dad came and bought us back. Dad came into the system in a host body like we got trapped in. He came and he took the same punishment that we were pun that was our punishment. He came into the host body, and so he took on the form of a man. The Holy Spirit impregnated Mary. It couldn't be a sperm, had to be the Holy Spirit itself. And then he lived a sinless life. He died on a cross as a proxy for your sins and mine. Dad came to buy us back. Don't you love Dad? I do. Dad is awesome. It's a custody issue. And that's what I was in with all this life thing that I did. I was in custody issues with kids. I was like, man, these girls are crazy. They're going for the throat. I'm like, wait a minute, just take it easy. And I won. Against all odds. And I had to be my own lawyer. Yeah, Dad's coming. Yeah. Anyway, very exciting stuff, guys. This is a very exciting time to be alive right now. Be encouraged, man. Now, I know some people don't have any clue what's going on. I read some comments. You guys need to catch up. Go watch You Are Exiles. Okay, just go watch the DVD on my channel, You Are Exiles. And then if you're like, just go back and watch. Let me try and remember the name of that DVD. I'll post it later. You Are Exiles, and there's another one. Not the Queen of Heaven, but there's another one that's really good where I broke down the hieroglyph the first time. It'll really help you. Anyway, but I'm excited, man. Dad's coming, guys. He's coming. You think it's an accident that that video loaded up and it was, let's see, where is it? Watch this. I'll go from here to my creator studio and recording number 50. I mean, that's just crazy. It just put it as recording number 50. That's just crazy. And the number 50 means, let's see, I got to read that again, just my brain. My father is rescue. Look at that. That's unbelievable. So, looks like dad's coming. So, yeah. Okay, zombies, 1916, 1961 Jaguar, cranberries, zombies since 1916. Okay, I got something for you. Whatever. All right, so it's time to go, guys. I mean, I would surmise that we're getting very close. I'm just going to say that. I would surmise that the time is very, very close at hand. All right, God bless. Be encouraged.